Well, good morning. It's Friday. I can tell because there's gardeners all over the place and there's tons of mowers and leaf blowers going and dust in the air just to make everything look nice. Go figure. I'm getting off to an early start here. I've got a couple of errands to run and then we have our 11 o'clock immediate family band management Zoom to do. Then I have another interview after that. Which I'm looking forward to. I really enjoy them. It's just, you know, some people say, God, you sound, you know, you kind of say some of the same things when you get interviewed. I'm getting the same questions. It's kind of hard to make them really different every time, you know, bring something new to the table. But every once in a while, I get a question that makes me go in a whole other direction, which is great. I appreciate those where they've really done their homework and they want to go a little bit deeper than, you know, what's James Taylor really like? Things like that. So just fed the pups. They're out there barking at the next door neighbor's dogs. They always visit at the fence and go crazy in the mornings, which I enjoy. You know, it's their social life. They're not as quarantined as we are. They can actually get close to the neighbors. So I was thinking about more stuff. I was watching Rick Beato's video about just copyright and blocking, and now he's got a strike, which none of us have ever heard of before. So I sent him a note just to see what's going on. I haven't heard back yet, but just curious what that's all about. You know, I don't understand this business at times. I mean, I've been in it a long time, and it's still... there's elements of it that are so completely elusive to me in terms of how things get handled. It's pretty weird. But, you know, thank God there's people like Rick out there that are, you know, all over this thing. And there's guys dealing with the national union and all the problems that we've got going on with our union for many, many years of incompetent investing and stuff, which has completely damaged the pension plan. And there's so many things you could get into with all this stuff. But I'd rather just do some music right now for the moment. And I was digging around last night. I'm always looking just to find, you know, things that I've forgotten about when I find them, I just kind of go, oh, God, you know, that was such a beautiful project. And I found one of those last night, and I thought I would share it today. It was not heavily arranged, but it was very methodically crafted. So I'm not going to play along with it because I really like what's on this record, and I don't think it would. I think I'd rather listen to it with some fidelity rather than me putting a bass part on top of it. And I've got my notes here. This is a record I did back in 1992 called Born to Love, and it's with Roberta Flack and Peebo Bryson, two of the best singers I've ever worked with. And it was just great. I suddenly dug that one. Oh, God, that was so good. It was so good. And the band on these tracks was wonderful. It was my dear soulmate, Carlos Vega, on drums. God, I miss him so much. Carlos was an absolute gift to a bass player. And he was a gift as a friend, and I miss him every day. I think about him. Bobby Hall was playing percussion. I loved Bobby. She was great. Jay Winding was playing keyboards on this, and Tim Mays playing guitar. And then the background singers were Mona Lisa Young and Shirley Brewer. I think it's Brewer. Yeah. Roberta and Peebo. We went to Japan, there's videos of David Foster in Japan, and it was a producer series, and Peebo came with us on that. That was from back, I think, in the 90s, and Peebo came with us, and Celine Dion, and I think Boys to Men. There was a whole bunch of people, but the band was absolutely unbelievable, and Warren Wiebe was with us, and Wendy Moten. It was great, but playing with Peebo then was really wonderful, and I did some stuff with Roberta. So having them together on this album was really something special. So I just want to start my day off with a couple of really beautiful songs by a couple of fabulous singers. The first one I'm going to play is called You're Looking Like Love to Me. Or if Barry White was there, You're Looking at Love to Me. Oh, I can't get down there. Even in the morning, I can't get down there. So here we go. This is just a beautiful ballad here. So check it out. Please, oh God, please, I'm so sick of this. I'm going to start it over again. This is not fair to a great song to have to put up with that crap. Just beautiful ballads, beautiful voices, great arrangement. Can't beat it. It's just great. Tim May, who's playing guitar in this stuff, for any of you who saw Back to the Future, the original one, when Michael J. Fox is at the prom and he starts playing guitar on it, that's all Tim May playing guitar on that. All of the Johnny B. Goode kind of thing on that. It's Tim's great. I've done many, many projects with Tim. He's one of the staples in the movie soundtracks too. He works a lot in that. Good cat, good fun guy. Here's one other. This is really a great song too. This is called "I Just Came Here to Dance." So again, this is Peebo and Roberta. I'm so glad I found this. I hadn't heard this stuff since we recorded way back in, like I said, in 92, we cut these tracks, this album. So that's been my fun adventure on this whole thing is rediscovering tracks. And, you know, a lot of people ask me, so like, when you listen, do you listen, you know, for your bass parts? And I don't know, not really at all. I listen to the entirety. That's what kind of drives me crazy a little bit when I'm actually playing along, you know, kind of demonstrating my bass parts on these. That's really not how I listen to music, to have the bass sitting on top of the track. I like to be, you know, in the track. I'm part of the orchestra, not the soloist. So it gets a little bit crazy for me sometimes when I'm doing those, because my perspective is not what I'm used to working with. But for the sake of demonstration, it's the way this whole channel started, and that's how it'll continue. But there are times like this where I just enjoy sitting back and listening to the entirety of a band and an artist playing, and then just kind of remembering how it felt in the studio, and especially when it's with people, when I hear stuff with people like Jeff Porcaro and Carlos Vega and Don Grolnick and Michael Brecker and on and on and on of so many of the great players I've worked with in my life that are gone now. You know, this is a real special moment to me, is hearing the artistry of these people and the contributions that they made. So here we go. Let's listen to one more here. This is great. I just came here to dance. Hopefully no commercial.
Now I can't recover. I was caught up in the music.
Credit for sax on this one. Always enjoyed doing these kind of duet projects. I remember doing an album with Johnny Mathis and Denise Williams, singing together with Billy Preston and Sarita, or like Linda Ronstadt and Aaron Neville. It's always great. It's always great. I always enjoy those. It's something really beautiful about getting really complimentary voices together, and just letting them go, So. See, I sent off a couple of tracks to New Orleans yesterday to Judith for her new album, because she's down there working, and they sent me a couple of songs, so I worked last night and sent them bass parts, and I'm waiting to hear back whether it's what, you know, usually we when we're in the studio, we really share ideas, so I'll see if these work. If not, I'll tweak them a little bit today, and I've got another song from Ian Pace that I'm going to work on today. So it ends up filling up the days. You know, there's lots to do. And at some point, I just want to be on the road. I just want to play live. But, yeah, we have to wait till it's right. So I'm going to get going right now. I'm off to the post office. I've got some books to deliver, and somebody bought one of my the prints of one of my paintings, and I've got it all done and packed and ready to ship. So I'm excited about that. It'll be nice to a couple things have been sold, and it's fun when people send me pictures of how they've got them displayed in their house or their studio or, you know, whatever. So lots of little things to take care of here. So I'm going to go get to that. I'm going to wish everybody a great day. Tomorrow I'm going to probably do a real abridged little thing, because tomorrow is my one-on-one Skype and FaceTime day. And that starts for me at about 7 a.m. and goes till about 4. And then I have a Zoom interview at 5 o'clock tomorrow. So I got a long day, so I'll probably find a little window in there somewhere and do something. Just give a shout out, because my weekend would suck without visiting you guys. And then Sunday I can jump in a little bit more. I got more leisurely day then. So take good care. Just stay safe. Stay safe for the sake of you and your family and your community. And we will get through it all. But I wish everybody a really nice weekend. And for those of you that, I guess, are into it, have a nice Super Bowl Sunday. Whatever. I enjoy, you know, watching a game or anything athletic if it's really great people, you know, at the top of their game. But I'm not a team person per se. I don't sit in and actually like root for a specific team. I root for performance. And it's great to see people that really do what they do so well. So I'm rambling again here. Sorry about that. You know, I'm up early a lot, wake up with lots of energy. I should do these in the middle of the night when I'm actually chilled a little bit. So. Okay. And as always, and I'm never going to stop this until it's over, thank you, thank you, thank you to all of the people that are working so hard every day. Again, we're entering into a weekend, and the people working in, especially the medical profession, don't get weekends. They are working around the clock 7 days a week, trying to save lives and keep our society afloat, and all the people that are doing all the jobs out there that are putting themselves somewhat in harm's way to maintain our society. Thank you all so much. So take good care, and I'll see y'all tomorrow. Okay. Bye-bye.